Well, very interesting journey so far today. Where are we headed, James?
We're going to Haunted Valley Trail. And we are on Forest Road 287.
Man, this is... incredible. This is like big stuff. This is unbelievable.
Yeah. You're like right in the middle of this mine currently.
Yeah, we're kind of like, going through this mine. Every time we turn around, oh my God, look at that.
We're literally in the middle of an open pit mine at the moment. It's kind of weird. These forest roads go straight through all the mining area. You got to kind of meander through a lot of closed areas, off limits areas to kind of find your way. It's pretty well marked though, right?
Yeah, you know, I haven't seen any reason that, you know, I'm just wondering if we're going to have four-wheel drive back up it. I mean, it's pretty,
Yeah, it's pretty rough, huh?
You know, it's not rough, but it's steep. Man, it's almost overwhelming that it's because it's so big, you know?
Yeah, we'll give you a little view here before we carry on our way.
But the road's not, I mean, we've been down a lot worse roads.
Yeah, we're in the right place.
This is definitely something that a lot of people might want to go do, depending on how cool it is. It's just so far, it's pretty cool, even though, you know. And we got nods and waves from all the mine people, so we definitely are on. Go back up. Haunted Canyon. I can kind of tell you why they call it Haunted Canyon, because it's just so quiet. It's really intriguing, though. I mean, it's kind of like you step into a whole nother world. That's what's so cool about Arizona, is that you all of a sudden you're in a different place and you're like, wow, this is like somewhere else in the Midwest or something like that. And in just a matter of a few miles. Oh, because that probably is not the road this is.
This is essentially like a turnout like we were running into.
Yes. I tell you, there's a cool ranch right there, and down in the middle, if you don't like people, this is definitely a place. It definitely looks like they go out this direction just as well as we do, because that road.
I hear people over there.
Well, the road, if we go back through the mine, it definitely is going to be a better road to take, is going back through. It doesn't look like they use that road there going out. So if we can cut through the mine, we'll cut through the mine. Whoa. But what does it say?
Trailhead.
Where?
Right there. Oral something trailhead. 3 miles.
Hurl Tree. 3.5 miles. Because this road doesn't even look, neither one of these roads look used. That's what's funny. So I'm trying to figure out which trail we should go down. And it appears to be, that's another 3.5 miles. Yeah. I'll be damned if anybody says that I'm spineless, James. So, you know, we're down this valley, and man, I'll tell you what, it's definitely, it's called Haunted Valley, and there might be a reason why it's haunted. You think?
Possibly.
Yeah.
Well, some had dinner, that's good.
Well, they're eating. But nobody's been down this road. I mean, this road's been pretty, we walked farther than I thought we would, because we were already back down here. So.
Yeah, it looks like the...
You know, So, after taking a couple detours, going to the ranch, we missed the little sign that said left. And so we missed that sign. At 287. So now we're in forest land, and it's kind of cool as we're all of a sudden dropping into the sycamores, which we'd planned to do a long time ago. We just didn't get it done. And now we see a sign that says closed. How can this be closed? Whoa. Well, there's the Iron Bridge, I'll bet, right there.
That is absolutely it.
Well, let's get out and take a look. Jace Wreck, Myths, Legends, Lies. Me and James, you know, there's a road right outside of Superior, and it kind of mirrors the highway, and it's got a gate, but we were told that you can walk this, and so we're walking up, and we're paralleling 60 over here, and we're walking up through the valley, and it's actually legal to do. Now, we've looked at this big wood hopper down here, and it's like, well, they didn't put it here for nothing, right? So you look at it, and you're like, well, wait a minute. Then we see a mine over there. We're like, oh, okay. But somehow, even down here with this hoppers, there had to have been some type of system, a rail system, something that they dumped those in to be able to go process them somewhere. Don't you think, James?
Oh, absolutely. Which might actually be this trail we're on now might have had something to do with that.
Well, I think
it's something to do with that single gauge or that.
That narrow gauge?
Narrow gauge, thank you.
Well, I think we ought to go over there and look at that. That is a hell of a hill to go down, but I think we should inspect this.
I'm in.
Should we inspect on the way back, though?
Yeah, we might go forward.
Yeah, we'll go forward.
We can actually get a lower point.
And we might be able to walk right in, because going up won't be a problem. But that was pretty steep going down, but I think we can do it. How much higher we are now, isn't that unbelievable? See, now what is that? We've got this hole that goes across, right? So show them the bridge real quick, James. So there's the bridge, right? Going over the old, this, we're on the old 60. There's the new 60. And then see this cave right here, right over there. We got to get down there to see. I don't see a fence like it's a cave that's a mine. It might be natural. And that's bizarre, though, because maybe it just goes in a little bit, but we're going to find a way to get down over there and get into this cave and see what it is, whether it's a mine or a cave. Now, there's another cave up on top of the hill. You can see it running across right there. Now, it's got bars on it, like it's a mine. But this doesn't really, it doesn't look like a mine. And maybe it is, but we need to get over there and see. So we're going to figure a way to get down and take a look at this. And try to figure out how to get down there safely, and then take a look and see what the hell we got, because all of a sudden it looks like
safely, wink wink.
So the cave goes in two ways. It goes down, which isn't too bad. Goes to the right and then goes straight down. And then there's to the left it goes. The problem with it is, it's definitely undercut. So I don't know if that's a false top on the top that could kind of go in. I'm not sure, but it's big. That is a big, you gonna go take a look?
Yeah, I'm just not gonna get the point of view in case.
Yeah, I think you can go back through that. Well, you like this stuff anyway. This is your baby. Could you see over that edge over there to the right?
Yeah, I tipped it over and tried to get my light as best as I could. I'll do it one more time for you if you want.
Yeah, extend it out if you can.
Okay. Oh, yeah, sorry. I forgot the periscope.
And that way we can kind of... If you go over the edge, I'll come get you.
I don't think there's any get me.
And then also light up that one alley back in the back to the...
Yeah, that's it, yeah.
It looks like there's trash back there. It looks like people have been back there.
Yeah, it looks like people hang out back there, dude.
See, what's funny is this thing should go in that way, right?
At some place it does. Way deep in there. These bats are like under the highway. That's really cool.
That's pretty cool. And then again, that has to be the sister mine. And it runs in this vein, right?
Yep.
You can almost see that like that. Now, because they probably couldn't get, well, I guess they could have got a dozer up there, but they chose not to. They chose to put steel. These mines have been around for 100 years. That's never, you know, the gas part. And I guess if we're serious about doing mines, then we need to get a meter that shows. But, you know, we don't do that. It's kind of like ghost stuff. We fall into it. You know, it's not something we go do, but it's not something we're afraid of going in either. But we probably ought to get some type of meter, because that's the only thing that bothered me is that it's gas. I mean, these mines, most of them, don't get me wrong, I'm not going to say they're super stable, but they've been around for 100 years, you know, and not to say that I couldn't be in here on the time an earthquake came, you know, it couldn't have been something like that. But the reality of it is that the gases are what would bother me more than anything. And, you know, there's a lot of guys that do a lot more cave stuff. We just go out, and when we see some, we just want to go in them because that's what we do. But we're not cavers, just like we're not ghost adventure guys. But you know what? If that's available and we're out doing what we do, man, that's awesome. I mean, I enjoy it. I really do. But we probably ought to get a little more involved in the cave side of it, because there's some unbelievably cool caves that, and mines alone that they're really fun to go in. How about you, James?
This one's a really fun one.
Well, there's a way out, or...
It's an easy way.
Well, I just, this looked okay.